Hey guys, this is Dave from Orchids and Fambus, and we're back with our first episode for 2018. In this episode, we focus on our orchid collection and the highlights and lowlights we experienced in 2017. This episode is part of the Orchid Reflections 2017 challenge by Maria Young, who said you better participate or else. And please check out our New Year's Eve video if you haven't seen it already, which recaps our orchid expeditions of 2017. And without further ado, let's get started. I think the first story I want to tell you about, titled An Enduring Spirit, is about one of my first no-ID Phalaenopsis orchids. I have yet to see such an enduring spirit such as this little one. In February 2017, she lost all of her roots due to root rot, but look how beautifully she's recovered and how many roots she has today. And here is our ribbon decorated Christmas tree, which I just had to show you. It's inspired by Garden Answer. Yes guys, without rain, without bad times, without trials, there will be no blooms. You need to get the bad to have the good. And here, as you can see, my BLC Memoria Helen Brown is back in bud and is about to bloom very soon. And here is my Vanda Mimi Palmer. I'm trying the teabag method of fertilizing, recommended by Maria Young from My Orchid Adventures. This orchid has not yet bloomed for me, but I'm hoping that the teabag method is going to be the key to success with this orchid. Next we have my Dendrocylums and a few of my Dendrobium orchids. Next, let's look at some of the spectacular blooms of 2017. One of my most memorable moments was when my Ansellia africana bloomed for the first time in the spring of 2017. Ansellia africana is an indigenous South African orchid and is also known as the leopard orchid. Then in December 2017, my Oncidium painted tropic jungle bloomed for the first time. I've had this in my care for almost a year. This orchid is a 4N mutation of the Oncidium Jungle Monarch and has a beautiful hyacinth-like fragrance. Another guy that's back in bloom just 6 months later is our Psychopsis kalihi, yellow bird. The last story I want to tell you about, titled A Swan Song, relates to my Disa coensis and is the biggest struggle that I faced with my orchid collection in 2017. I had quite a few struggles with her throughout the year, from fungal infections or bacterial infections, I'm not quite sure, to aphids and mealybugs, you name it, she pretty much had it. Every time I thought I got over one infection, it was the next thing. Anyways, I managed to get her through to December of 2017 with three new growths and she seemed to be doing okay. Even started producing two new flower spikes. Then we had a super hot day here in Cape Town and she wilted and just spiraled down from there. Being the flagship of my YouTube channel and one of the most precious orchids in my collection, it was quite a blow. Amazingly, before she died, she put out one final flower, a swan song, so that we should never forget her magnificent beauty. If you would also like to participate in the Orchid Reflections 2017 challenge, please check out Maria Young's channel at MY Orchid Adventures.